Hey everyone, this is Zach, and today we're going to explore how to use WordPress, an open-source content management system platform built on PHP, an SQL language, to manage websites without coding or needing to know how to use tough HTML or CSS files. In just a few minutes, we're going to build a website from scratch. WordPress is available through two options. WordPress.com is a paid hosting service that has limitations when editing your website with a free plan. WordPress.org is completely free, but it needs to be installed by the following online manual, or directly through your hosting server dashboard specifying directory, admin account, credentials, and so on. In this video, we will assume that you have a website with its domain already associated with a server host and WordPress already installed on it. For more information, please check out the links in the video description. Once WordPress is installed on your server host, you get two links. The first one is the website's homepage showing a default WordPress template. The second one is the login page that includes your domain, installation directory, and either WP admin or WP login. Enter your admin username and password to access the WordPress dashboard, which is the main interface for managing and editing your website. To see a preview of your website, click on My Blog, Visit Site. Keep this tab open to easily view any future changes you make. Your website starts with a default theme, its homepage, sample pages, and a header on top, and footer at the bottom. We recommend starting editing your website appearance first, and then focus on its content with posts and pages. Under Appearance, Theme, you can change the theme applied on your website. A theme is a ready-made template that defines the site's layout, colors, and element placement. Pick any theme and go to Activate to apply it, as you can see by refreshing the page. To search for other themes, click on Add New Theme, or using the search bar on the right. You may need to install any theme before applying it to your website. To edit the theme, go to Appearance, Customize. The options available depend on the specific theme you are using and may be limited on free plans. Click on Site Identity to change your site title, description, and logo. You can also upload images from your computer to your media library and crop them to fit your needs. Click on Site Icon and browse for any image to set as favicon, which is the small logo next to the browser tab. You can apply these site changes with Publish in the top left corner. Switch to Front Page Settings to edit the central page layout, including the number of slides, automatic transitions, or a different banner by adding call to actions, any video, or a YouTube link. You can also change the image background, the title and subtitle, and the button links. In sidebar layouts, you can change the layout of pages and posts. Go to Styling Settings, and then to Color Settings to modify the background color of the site, and to Background Image to add a background image by adjusting its position, size, or making it repeatable or fixed on page. In General Settings, you can add or edit elements like the search bar, the social links, and both the header and footer, for example to add copyright notes. In homepage settings, choose whether to show your latest posts or a specific page on your homepage. Then click to publish to apply changes and see the results. Now let's cover how to create and write posts. Return to the dashboard and select Posts to get all the existing posts of your website. By default, a single one called Hello World. you can create a new post with Add New. This opens the block editor, which allows you to write and edit the post using independent blocks of text, media files, or HTML codes. Type the post title, and then its body text at the bottom. Use the plus button to create new blocks, for example, a heading title, under an HTML H tag that is larger in size and bold. Use the dialog box above to adjust the block alignment or text distribution within the block. You can also select text to set its style or add a hyperlink. You can also click on More and set the font color and background color with highlight. And make the text strike through, subscript, or superscript. Inside Options, you can copy, duplicate, insert new blocks before or after the current one, or edit the source code of the block. Come back to the block editor with Edit Visually. Click on Remove to delete the block. You can undo any action with Control or Command and Z. The block panel on the right offers further options for the selected block. You can customize the font color and background color by applying solid colors or gradients. Set text size, appearance, and letter case, but not the font family, since this is coming from the website theme. Use Enter to start with a new line, so a new paragraph block can be edited and rearranged. You can also copy and paste content, or select text to customize it, as seen for the heading. To add other blocks, click on the top left corner. Use the Undo, Redo buttons to reverse or restore changes. On the right, under Post, set Visibility, Release Date, and Post Address called Permalink. Select the author, the categories we are going to see, and the tags to improve search rankings. On Featured Image, upload a thumbnail image for the post. On top, save as draft, and use Preview to see the post appearance across desktop, tablet, and smartphone screens. When selecting any paragraph, use the buttons above to make bulleted or ordered lists. Add an image block to upload a picture from your computer, from the media library, or through a URL, typing captions at the bottom. Adjust image alignment. Add hyperlinks on it, or enable crop to make several modifications, such as adding text overlay, changing the aspect ratio, or rotating the image by 90 degrees. Resize by dragging nodes, and get more options from the block panel on the right. Add a classic block to use the classic editor, a gallery block to insert an image gallery, or a YouTube block to embed a video. See our link in the video description for more information on WordPress blocks. You can access all your created posts by opening the Posts section. Use Edit to modify, or Trash to remove any. When getting loads of posts, you may arrange these under several categories. By default, all of them belong to the uncategorized category, but you can create a new one from categories on the left. Add any name, its slug, or URL word, and assign the category to any post with Quick Edit. When you open the category link, this shows only the posts belonging to it. Now, let's see how to add pages. With respect to posts, these do not have authors or publication date, so they never get old when listed. You can create a new page with Add New above, and edit it with the block editor as seen. These pages are not accessible until you share their URL address. For example, in a menu bar. To create a menu, go to Appearance, Menus. Set the menu name and its items at the bottom. For example, remove the sample page. and add other items from the left, such as pages, the home page, posts, or even custom links and categories. You can also drag and drop items to reorder them or make sub-items. Once you are done, click on Save Menu to make your menu live. The WordPress features can be extended by installing third-party plugins, such as the classic editor to use the old WordPress editor, or any cookie plugin to comply with the GDPR regulations. Remember to build a proper privacy policy page as well. You can visit free sites like privacypolicygenerator.info and insert your company name, website name, URL, and answer quick questions. Then copy and paste the HTML code in your privacy page and save it. Keep this page always accessible from your site, for example, from its footer. From the left side of the dashboard, you can manage user comments and registered users. And under Tools, Site Health, check the safety level of your website. In Settings, change the website title and description, or tagline, appearing on search engines, the homepage URL, the admin email address, the user permissions, and much more. Thank you very much for watching this video. Don't forget to check out our YouTube channel and our website for more free and outstanding guides on websites and artificial intelligence completely for free.